Good evening and welcome. Good evening and welcome. We're very delighted to be playing for you this evening. All of us that you'll see on stage this evening, we have three groups for you. My name is Tom Strait. I'm the coordinator of the commercial music program here at MSUM, and tonight is our jazz night, and we do it different every semester, kind of in terms of how many groups perform and which groups and all that. This semester we thought we would do just kind of a showcase of our jazz groups in general, which includes the jazz combo, which you see in front of you right now, and then they will be followed by our guitar ensemble under the direction of Eric Martins, and then our jazz ensemble, or better known to people my age as a big band. And what will happen is our combo will play three tunes for you, and then there won't be any break. They're going to come off, the guitar ensemble will come on and play their set for you, and Eric will tell you all about the selections they're performing. And then there will be a short break, maybe just enough time to hit the restroom if you need it, get them off and get set for the jazz ensemble. Thank you so much for coming out. We wish the weather could have been as nice as it was a few days ago, but nonetheless, we appreciate your attendance. And again, this is the Jazz Combo, and this is a group that takes different shapes from semester to semester. What I mean by that is that we have the big band, which will close the show tonight, but we also have this offering, a small group where improvisation is maybe a little more featured. The students in the group range from those individuals that have a fair amount of jazz experience playing in the jazz ensemble, maybe. I think we have three of the folks are also in their jazz ensemble. The rest of the folks are maybe fairly new, if not brand new, to jazz. So, you know, it's kind of it's great to get these students together and learn from each other. And I'm going to kick off the first tune, but then our trumpet player, Kevin, is going to take it from there. If you have the program, I think they talked about it in the announcement, you can follow along. This first tune is a standard blues called Sunny Moon for Two, and this is the MSUM Jazz Combo. Thank you.
thank you. This next song that we're going to be playing is Killer Joe by Benny Golson.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here. No, we really appreciate it. This isn't easy, even though, I don't know, maybe we hopefully make it look like that. But I know the first song, we didn't even have music, so yeah, it goes a long way to see you guys all here. Lastly, this last song we'll play is Take the A-Train, heavily inspired by Duke Ellington. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks for coming out to hear some jazz at MSUM tonight. This is the guitar ensemble. That was Griffin over here on taking a solo on the tune Stylin'. Up next, we have... Yes. Up next, we got the classic bossa Black Orpheus. And you'll hear a little trading between Griffin and our drummer Josiah. Thank you, and just a quick applause. Sydney was playing the melody, and Kim was doing this really interesting and cool counter melody. I don't know if you caught that, but they worked hard on that together. So Sydney and Kim also. Our last tune of the night is this really, I've loved this song for many, many years. It's called Stolen Moments. It's written by Oliver Nelson. I highly recommend you go check out the recording of him on his album, The Blues and the Abstract Truth. They've got an absolutely stellar lineup of musicians consisting of Freddie Hubbard, Eric Dolphy, Bill Evans, Paul Chambers, and Roy Haynes. So some of the biggest names in the jazz scene in the 1960s. It's a really, you're going to hear it. It's got some really interesting harmonies. It's a 16-measure melody followed by a regular standard 12-bar minor blues. And you're going to hear from all three of our guitarists and also Joe back there on bass. So I hope you enjoy the next tune.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. This is the MSUM Jazz Ensemble in front of you. And this first tune was an original by possibly the most prominent jazz ensemble composer of today, certainly one of the most prominent, a gentleman by the name of Gordon Goodwin. He's been on the scene for quite a while, but he's just now in the past few years sort of garnered the recognition and accolades he truly deserves. He's based out of Los Angeles, and the CDs he puts out on a fairly regular basis now for the past several years include some of the most cream of the crop studio musicians in Los Angeles on that scene. And for that reason, they don't tour very much because, you know, they would be losing work if they left town for any length of time. But occasionally they do get out, and if you ever do have a chance to catch them, or if you're in Los Angeles, you'll be in for a treat if you go hear them. That introduced our first soloist of the evening, and on trumpet, how about a hand for Kevin Bjorgen? On lead alto sax, how about it for Elijah Davis? And we're doing something this evening that we don't always do. We often do it, but actually we don't often do two guest soloists on the same program. And so helping us out on guitar this evening, doing a masterful job as he always does, is Eric Martins. And we'd like to continue now with a tune from another contemporary big band, a composer-arranger who actually has been here in our midst. It's been a few years, but he did a spring concert with us maybe 10 years ago or so, the great Bob Mincer. He's currently the tenor saxophonist with a great fusion group called the Yellow Jackets. Some of you may be familiar with that group. And this is a composition of his was on an album or a CD a few years back, but it's a chestnut. I think it still holds up quite well. And this is going to feature on piano for the first time Brady Larson. Okay, well, the first time with this group, he was playing in the combo, so you heard him earlier. But Brady's going to play, and we'll feature Eric again on this tune, and it's called New Rochelle.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was New Rochelle, Bob Menzer. How about another hand for Brady Larson on piano? And our guest guitarist, Eric Martins. Those boys play well. We're going to now introduce our other featured guest soloist. I have to say, don't get me started, but I've been here a long time now, and I've always been proud of my colleagues and the faculty here at MSUM in the music department, and always, but especially now. I'm just so fortunate to work with these people on a daily basis, and I'll do the official thanks before we're done with the program, but right now I just want to say that, you know, it's truly a team effort here. I play just a small part of the equation in putting this music together for you. And so most of the students that you see in front of you study privately with our at least somebody, and in some cases more than one of our faculty members. And this gentleman came to us after serving as a public school band director in the region for many years, and is helping us now out now teaching woodwinds for us. And he's a fabulous musician, and we're going to have him come out and do a ballad for you. This is a great jazz ballad standard called Lover Man, and please welcome to the stage Paul Liversage. is Kevin Bjorgen, graduating this term. Also graduating this term is our pianist, Brady Larson. Hand for Brady. And this next young gentleman came to us, came to me as a total surprise. He's not a music major, and he just showed up to auditions the first week of classes 4 years ago, or five, or whatever it was, last week. I can't remember. And was just a great surprise. He came from a really great program over at Davies High School, and he plays the tuba, but he also plays a mean bass trombone, and he does that for us in this ensemble. And this tune is a bass trombone feature, and I like to do bass trombone features from time to time. If for no other reason, it reminds me I have to get my driver's license renewed. That used to go over so much better. this is another standard, sort of from Tin Pan Alley. I think most of you know the tune or have heard it, and this is a great arrangement by Dave Wolpe of the standard Makin' Whoopee. And I'd like to welcome now Seth Hansen. Yes, that was nice. That always feels good. Every time we play that, it feels great. We're going to bring Professor Paul Liversage back to the stage right now, and we're going to do a tune that probably my favorite tune from one of my jazz heroes, the great Dizzy Gillespie. And you know, when I hate saying this because it makes me sound so old, but I find myself saying it more and more often. When I was your age, they're getting sick of me saying that. But you know, it was pretty straightforward. You know, if you're a music major, you know, we had a jazz band. I'm not that old. We had a jazz band, but usually, like on senior recitals, there was no jazz. It was all classical, and I really wanted to do a jazz tune, and I was able to persuade my teacher and the powers that be to do one. And this is the one I did, different arrangement. It was just a combo, not a big band, but you know, it's always been near and dear to my heart, and it's great to have Paul join us on this. This is the great Dizzy Gillespie's Night in Tunisia. Thank you. Paul Liversage, yes, how about that? Dizzy Gillespie's Night in Tunisia. So I'm curious, just by a show of hands, how many of you folks fairly regularly come to our jazz events here at MSUM? Okay, a number of you. So if you're among those, you probably dread when I get on the microphone. I wouldn't blame you. I shouldn't even be let near one in my career. But I'm going to talk just a little bit to give particularly our brass players a little bit of a break. Drink some water. Talk amongst yourselves. I'll give you a topic. No. I was thinking about this recently, you know, because I'm always thinking about this stuff. You know, it's really an important part of my life, you know. They say you're not your job, but, you know, sometimes I think I am, you know, because I spend most of my time doing it. And where I guess non-classical music is concerned, we're kind of in an interesting place these days, because I'll give you an example. What we now are calling our commercial music program, we used to call it jazz studies, and there are still many jazz studies programs in the nation, and some of them are quite successful. We talked about it amongst ourselves on the faculty and the administration, and we decided to kind of cast a wider net, because, you know, we realize as much as I love jazz, and it's a big part of my background and my life, I realize that I'm getting older, the younger people are getting younger. It's funny how that works. And whereas it's great when I encounter young people that love jazz and want to do it, there are other people that, you know, there's other types of music, obviously, rock, pop, etc., that's being made and being made very well and is every bit as artistically valid as jazz or classical music. And so we decided to go in that direction and certainly not lose jazz. So I hope and I feel like that jazz still has a place in this equation. And I really thank you guys for supporting it. And so it's kind of like I'm preaching to the choir right now. But it's something I very strongly believe in. I think that if we're not there already, I feel like that some of the earlier jazz, for example, up through the middle 20th century, for example, I think it's very similar when you hear that music now. It's very similar to somebody going to a symphony orchestra concert and hearing the classics, you know. So instead of going to hear a Beethoven symphony or a Mozart symphony or a Brahms symphony, you can go hear Duke Ellington. You know, you can hear something by Dizzy Gillespie, for example. So I really do, I feel very strongly that it has a place. And so I just want to thank you for supporting that. And if you enjoyed yourself tonight, I hope that you'll kind of mention it to your friends and neighbors. Hey, go check out not just us, because the other two schools, they have a really good jazz bands too. But, you know, obviously I'm a little prejudiced for our neck of the woods here. This closing tune is a little interesting, and I'll give you a little background. I don't normally play with the band. You see, I've got my trumpet up here, because I feel like it's not about me; it's about the band. The exception would be when we go out and play a tour or a run-out concert at a local school. I might play a tune with the band, So the kids, you know, get to hear somebody more experienced, and I always enjoyed it. So we had a an event planned, a run-out performance at a school that unfortunately fell through due to scheduling. And so we had worked up this tune, or we're working up this tune that we're about to close the concert with. And I was not planning on playing it this evening, but I thought, well, I don't know, maybe it would work. And I literally, you know, it's my band, I get to do what I want, right? But I did ask the band, and you said yes, you said it was okay, right? Do you remember?
No.
Oh. I swear I did ask, and they said it was okay. Anyway, this is a tune from the Maynard Ferguson Library, and for those of you that are true jazz and true big band fans, you know that name, and he's no longer with us. One of the greatest trumpet players ever on the planet, and certainly the king of the high register of the trumpet. There was nobody that did it better than Maynard. And to be quite honest with you, any other trumpet player attempting to play a Maynard Ferguson arrangement, it's a fool's errand. But for some reason, that doesn't stop most trumpet players, including myself. So I'm going to give it a shot here. And I maybe need a second to get my lip back after you know, I get cold really easily. This is going to feature as well our lead trombonist, Jake. And this is a, yes, Jake. And this is a tune by an arranger named Jay Chataway that most of you probably don't know that name, but he was the fella that arranged Maynard's hit single in the 1970s on the theme from Rocky. How many people remember that? Okay, it's like one of the last instrumental jazz singles that made the charts, you know. And I was in high school when it came out and got the album and everything. And so he arranged this tune as well. And this is a tune made popular by Elton John. And most of you know the way he does it. And this has just got a lot of different textures in it. It's mostly rock, but it has some swing in it. And even a sort of a quasi, never knew how to pronounce that word, classical section, like a Baroque fugue in the middle of it. And it's going to feature Jake, and it's Maynard's version of Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Me. And with that, thank you so much again for supporting live music and supporting live jazz and supporting these wonderful students that we have for you. Thank you so much. Oh, I am so sorry. I did forget to I forgot to thank some very important people. They're in your program, but in case you didn't bring your device with you or have trouble seeing or hooking up or whatever, and I'm probably going to leave some people out. The applied faculty that are responsible, most of these students, again, they take lessons. And so you met Paul Eversage, you met Eric Martins, but also Doug Neal, who teaches low brass and bass for us. Is an important part of our team. Kenyon Williams and Dave Eiler and Matt Tingem teach our percussionists or drummers, as the jazzers call them. I do want to mention a very dear friend of mine who unfortunately left us earlier in the semester, and it was a huge blow to the musical community in Fargo-Moorhead. Tom Christensen had taught for us at various times over the years, and I think maybe we'd like to dedicate this concert to his memory. He was such a great friend and an impeccable musician. Also, the people that help out with the logistical end of things. Our great sound engineer, Ryan Kofer, back there, and his team. How about a special round of applause for Ryan's work? And then the people that are responsible for making sure that our facility is available and it works would be Elizabeth Everett Carnes and Amanda Satrowski. and our departmental administrative assistant, Melissa Howard. And I believe I did leave off, unfortunately, it was an oversight, but our director of bands, Ben Druffel. Now, he's our wind ensemble director, which is a kind of a different kind of music, but most of the students, at least the wind players, play in that group. And so they get to play, you know, 5 days a week, which is really important. We only get to rehearse 2 days a week. And so, you know, keeping the horn on the face and playing music at a high level, it's just great. So thanks to him. And I think that may be everybody. It's in your program if I did leave somebody out. So anyway, don't let the sun go down on me. Chops got cold again. For those of you in the front rows, I apologize. You might want to see your audiologist next week. Okay? I wish I were joking. MSU Moorhead Jazz Ensemble. Thank you again for coming. See you next time. Bye.